she's on it. If Samira can get in the back line really quick with her dashes and ult with an Ornn behind her, then she's definitely doing a lot of damage. But that's a Jax last pick into the Ornn. So Broken Blade being Broken Blade, going for his side lane potential there. But Fnatic have the tools to use the global of the TF. It's a bit hard to go up to the top side, but bot lane is probably where they're looking. Unless they can get the Jaxi out and go for the all-in.
Now the knockup, Whipple continuing to extend here. Empowered auto, Nisqy on the way in. Already burned the Counter-Strike, can't block that. First blood coming through. Blade over-aggressive there on extending that trade.
Yeah, way too aggressive. And it looks like Fnatic's going to do the Drake as well. So they're going to win out on top side. They're going to win out on bot side as well. So that's a huge play for the side of Fnatic. All Gilius can really do is just look to clear his top caps.
Cost him a decent amount in terms of overall clear speed, as Fnatic right now are just grabbing this Drake uncontested and on vision.
Yeah, if you looked what Selfmade did there, if anyone's trying to become a pressure giant support, whereas Gilius and Limit seem off sync. Gilius on his Krugs, Limit's trying to contest bot side vision, and this is what happens.
Pullback, suppress, Limit now running for the hills. Aftershock still procs, he's got a few more moments. Big Haymaker, the follow-up is going to connect. And for Neon, he might just be in trouble. The pullback is just going to dunk him down. The immediate gold card follow-up, all too easy. Cleanse not going to work out for Neon, trying to dash to safety, but here comes Upset, not even going to need to use the ultimate. Doesn't even have enough style points to do it, but it's not going to matter. He's going to grab the kill.
Yep, good play there from the side of Fnatic. Nisqy identifying that Neon was a little bit too far up and Hillisang was on the way.
She already has the Immortal Shield bow, but once she gets the Collector too, this is going to be a very difficult champion to shut down in fights. And at this stage, I don't even think Schalke really want to be forcing larger scale fights against the lineup of Fnatic. They need Broken Blade to get a few more items under his belt. He's going to want to take this fight, but they will have to fight for the next one.
Exactly, and you can see Selfmade did the exact same thing as he did with the first Herald. Herald mid, pushing the wave. Schalke has to respond both of them, but it's just not enough so far because the global gold and the neutral objective Fnatic have been picking up here. I think Gilius just keep
forward.
Zhonyas.
They're going to get Galliwald as well as Zhonyas. Gilius still looks like he's going to drop again. Selfmade from downtown finding that one. Big Fat Haymaker coming in from Hillisang. Won't be enough to save his life, but that's the one for one priority access to the mid lane. And now it looks like tier one tower as well.
This is how they need to play the game. Look at bot. Abadage needs to start engage from Whippo. They actually have to kill Whippo first. This engage comes in onto Abadage. He has no cleanse.
Very good. Blast Cone though going to take him out of safety. Flash over the wall. Now he's sleepy.
Riddled.
Lucian all. Gonna knock Nisqy out of it. Selfmade now retreating as we see a fight on the top side of the map. Broken Blade trying to all in Whipple. Maybe he can get the 1v1, but that's a knockup now coming in. Whipple gonna dash to the safety, but he blocked by his own. No! The leap into the tower! Are you kidding me? Gold TFT, baby! Whipple finding that in the end. I cannot believe it.
Selfmade.
Fight balanced on the knife's edge, but now another one kicking off the mid lane. Gilius running for the hills.
He's gonna use the ult.
Oh, he mistimed it! Oh, he stands still. He knew he mistimed it.
There you go. Now Hillisang back on the way, and he's also going to go. All right. Well, as much as we praise Fnatic for not throwing anything away, they're getting a little bit ahead of himself. That's going to be the three-man taunt. Good from Limit, but he has no follow-up here. Abadage stepping forward. Gold card going to finish the job. Upset looking in. He's one off. That's the S-style rank. Spin, spin, spin.
Inferno trigger. My name is Samira. I'm balanced.
Yeah, it's a tough situation, though. Most certainly, Caitrol.
They're TPing in, though. Nisqy wants to contest this dragon. They're 2v3, but Upset is moving through mid. He's sitting on all of gold, so this fight could be somewhat even, but I think that Fnatic, Nisqy coming out of base, Hillisang getting a good position. I don't think they can take away the dragon, but they can take the fight.
Tortnoth, they have not backed it. Can they steal it? No, Gilius just barely able to grab that one away. Now running for the hills is going to throw it out. They're going to be a little bit slower, but here comes Whippo from downtown. Call the Forge God, going to knock up two. Hillisang fishing for the follow-up. Walking forward, the entire team here. Fnatic, an absolute death ball. Upset, S rank ready to go. He can ult at any moment, but they're going to...
It was pretty clean.
It was very clean mechanics.
Actually,
the back step to dash through was clean.
Yeah,
was
a little wave clear. And you can see that on the champions, right? Lucian, Jax, Lilia, there's really not much wave clear here. Only the Kaiser Q is the only thing you've got. So Fnatic are able to step up and start chunking the towers. But the ult comes out from Gilius.
Back off. Only managing to sleep one. Cool. And very difficult. The sad news is, if they were a little bit closer in this game, Fnatic don't necessarily have the best sieging potential. They have two short-range AD threats on this team, but Nisqy alone, with that gold card and the massive gold lead the Fnatic have built for themselves, are putting them in a position to just run through Schalke's base. Schalke not comfortable to force a fight on their own terms, on their own territory, and Fnatic now going in, looking to get things kicked off. Eyes on Upset as he fishes for the reset. Broken Blade, that's disastrous because the Counter-Strike is now down, and that is free reign for Fnatic to run through this fight. S available for Upset. He's going to start to spin. He's going to look for one. He can double rush through for another, but he's not going to go for the follow-up, playing it nice and slow. Broken Blade blocking the gold card. Fnatic Bassett. You're 2 minutes away from Drake, and Nisqy's teleporting into most likely one-shot Gilius here. Gilius is going to run for the hills, though. Protobelt giving him that extra move speed. Oh,
I think he's...
Oh, there it is.
He timed it right this time.
This time he got it.
Now he's standing still saying he's got it this time.
Give him the little heart. All right, so I think that's 3 for 4 for Selfmade, which is a C, but we'll take those on the
We take those. And Fnatic, even though the dragon's spawning in 1 minute, they're ignoring Broken Blade. They know that the only objective here is this top tower. So they're going to try and engage on it, try and force him back from the tower to make sure they get this objective.
Fishing, but going wide, is going to find a single knockup, interrupted by Limit now as the entire team retreats. But oh no, the stun card lands, upset immediately there for the follow-up. Broken Blade going to try to fish through, but the double rush back, now looking for the S tier. Now the spin, and that's it. Upset moving through as Selfmade finishes the job, and Fnatic, this should just be the slow, clean closeout here. A nice turn to the end of their first week as they're looking to finish it out in style. The dunk back, the massive haymaker across the team. It's going to be three members sleep, though. There's no follow-up.
There's no follow-up.
Niski didn't get slept. He still has the gold card. They can't do anything to walk forward, and that means Fnatic. Schalke just going to have to watch as their base is torn to pieces. Fnatic and Schalke both going to finish the week at 1-2, but Fnatic will find a win in week 1.
Yeah, really clean game from Fnatic, I think.